So class 12th, we are focusing on the new topic in your practical, and this is your titration. And you have already done in your class 11, but that was a different titration which we have done. But today we'll do the titration that is between hydrated ammonium iron 2 sulfate against your potassium magnate 7. In some books it is potassium magnate 7 written, or sometimes teachers are saying potassium per magnate. So basically KMnO4. So we'll do the titration here, and we'll see how we can complete this titration and how we can get the titer value in your titration. So we have made different solutions, different apparatus. We'll discuss it in the when we move forward in the video. I'll discuss with the entire thing. I want to explain you the different apparatus that is being used. So you are seeing that this is the measuring cylinder, and you see in your schools also that we have different measurements for the measuring cylinder. Over here we have it's about 100 ml its capacity. This is the pipette that has been used. This one is your conical flask. These are the beakers, and these two beakers are of 250 ml capacity. This is about 150 ml capacity. This is the burette stand, and this is your burette. Now when you look through your burette, you'll see it has been marked, and you will see the zero is on the top. And when you go down, you'll see the 50 is here, this side. So the entire capacity of this burette is about 50 ml. So you have to keep it in mind, the capacities of the apparatus. And this is the clips. Over here you have to hold your burette. Now again we'll focus towards your pipette. This is a glass pipette, and every schools have different measurements. In our schools we have 25 ml capacity, and it has been, you see, it has been opened from both the side, this side also and this side also. From this part you have to suck the solution, and it has been marked. When you see, it is a marked over here. So till here you have to fill the whatever the chemical you are using, or whatever the chemical you want to pour out from your pipette, it has been marked here. So till this position you have to fill up the solution. So these are the apparatus that has been used. So what are our duties? I have already taken the solutions in the different you can say beakers. So this is potassium per magnet. It has been there in your beaker, that's capacity of 250 ml. This is also ammonium iron 2 sulfate solution, basically it's hydrated, and it is also, we have taken the solution over here. So this particular beaker is having your sulfuric acid, dilute sulfuric acid. Everything will be provided to you. And this is the conical flask over here. In this only we do our titration process. So, and this particular measuring cylinder is being used to measure your dilute sulfuric acid. What is the basically the procedure for this experiment? The procedure is already given in your question paper, but over here I am doing what I'll do first. We'll fill the burette with KMnO4. So before filling the KMnO4 in your burette, you have to clean the burette. It has been already cleaned with the distilled water and KMnO4 solution also. And after cleaning it, I'll show how you can clean it with the KMnO4 solution. So water, as normal, you are pouring from the top. It is a knob. It has been opened, and you can open and close from here. So this knob has this duty. So let's see how we can fill this burette, or how we can resin this burette with KMnO4. So first I am trying to resin this burette. So I put the funnel over here. Over here I'll add small amount of KMnO4 through it. So you can see from the top you can add, and it is coming down. So this is the way, and I have opened the knob also, and you are seeing that the entire the KMnO4 has risen the burette, and it has been come down. I have taken a separate this thing beaker. You can use some other apparatus also. You can use conical flask, it's your choice. So I have just cleaned my burette with the small amount of KMnO4. This amount is, you can take around 5 ml or 6 ml, not more than that. For that entire burette will be clean, and now you can close the knob also. So I'll fill up this burette till 50 ml. Now you can see I have filled up the burette till zero has been marked over here. Until here I have filled the burette. and you can see the tap is being, this knob is being closed. Now my next step is I'll pip it out this AFS in this pipet, and you'll see that its amount, I've already mentioned you that its capacity is about 25 ml. In different schools we have different size of pipets, like 20 ml is been also been used in different schools, but in my school we are using 25 ml size of the pipet. So this is the capacity of the pipet, or the size of the pipet is about 25 ml. So we'll fill up this AFS till here with the, you have to suck with the help of the mouth, and then only it comes up. So you can see I have already filled up this pipette, and now I'm just placing the entire solution of AFS in the conical flask. So it's come like that, and simply you have to wait that all the solution should come down in your conical flask. Never try to pour the solution from the top. Always put your this thing pipette down, and then you'll see the entire solution will come out. And you can see over here, you can just have this thing, but never try to blow any air or this thing to remove all the liquid, because whatever has to come has been come down. So please make sure. So this way you can pour your this thing, ammonium iron 2 sulfate solution, or hydrated, whatever hydrated ammonium iron 2 sulfate is being poured in here. So now the next step is we have to take the measuring cylinder, and this is your dilute sulfuric acid. This will be also provided to you by your school, by your teacher, and just see the question paper how much they are asking to take this dilute sulfuric acid, whether it is 20 ml or 25 ml, it will be written in the question paper, and the procedures are different. So just try to fill up with it. It's around 20 ml. I'm using 20 ml, so you can also take 20 ml. But please, before doing your experiment, it is my humble request, read the procedure, whatever is being mentioned in the question paper. So it's around 20 ml that is being filled. Now the next duty is you simply pour this 20 ml dilute sulfuric acid in your conical flask. Try to mix it up, then we'll do the titration. You put it here just below the burette. Now please make sure that children are always, while filling up this burette, they always keep their funnel on the top. This is should not be made. When once you have filled up your burette, the funnel should be removed. Now you will start your titration, and the knob from down you will open it, and you will see that when you will open it, then the solution will come down, and it's better always focus down, don't see up how much has been poured. So this way you can just add your, initially you can pour more, and then you can, you have to continuously, in the continuation you have to shake it well, so that as soon as the KMnO4 has been dropping from the top, it's disappear. A time will come when this KMnO4 will not disappear, its color, its this particular solution changes color from white to light pink. So at the very point when you get the light pink color, that is your end point, or that is your titer value. So you'll see that how I am pouring. So yeah, you see now, as soon as I am adding it has been disappeared, but you have to shake it well. So this solution will be, you can see how it has been going on, and you can, don't focus on the top, just see where's, like I'm pouring the solution, how much has been there, around I think approx 7, something like that. So that has been there, so yes, 7, it has been 7 that has been poured down. So this way you can just do your experiment and see the point comes when your pink color appears. So that is your end point, or the titration point, right? So let's focus on it, the how it is there. So you can see how the, it's been coming down, and around 20 ml is been poured down in, and just see the color, still the color has been not come yet, it is colorless. So you have to add it and just see what the reading is coming. A point will come when the pink color will be retained, it will not disappear as you are adding KMnO4. It is, as soon as you are adding, it is disappearing, but a time will come it will be retained, or it will be there for till the end, and that point you have to calculate, and you have to observe, and that is your titer value, or the end point that comes. So we are just focusing on it, how it has been coming down, एंड नेवर अगेन आई एम टेलिंग यू नेवर सी ऑन द टॉप के वॉट द सोल्यूशन या हाउ मच इज़ बीन पोर्ड आउट. यू हैव टू सी दैट हाउ वेन द पिंक कलर इज़ बीन कमिंग. सो दैट पॉइंट इज़ योर एंड पॉइंट. सो स्टिल इट इज़ नॉट देयर. वी आर जस्ट वेटिंग फॉर इट. सो आई एम जस्ट एडिंग ड्रॉप बाई ड्रॉप एंड आई एम शेकिंग इट सो दैट द पिंक कलर कम एंड इट बीन देयर फॉर अ लॉन्गर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. इट विल कम वेरी सून. सो बिकॉज इट्स रीडिंग कम्स अराउंड लाइक 28 और इन समवॉट अबाउट 29. सो लेट्स सी वेन इट कम्स द पॉइंट वेन इट्स कम वील स्टॉप एडिंग द KMN4 एंड वील क्लोज द नॉब. सो वी हैव टू वेट टिल देन. सो यू आर सीइंग दैट आई एम शेकिंग इट कंटिन्यूसली एंड वी आर वेटिंग फॉर द पिंक कलर टू कम. So even though we can increase it so that it comes fast. See when it is coming around. So we'll see to it and let's see. Let's add few more drops. Just see, it has come. So you have to, at that point, you have to close the knob and just see, it's retained here. The pink color has been, it's been there. And now your duty is to see that when you have got the pink color. So just see, you can see in the light how the pink color is coming. So it's a light pink. So the point where you get the pink color, that is your end point or the titer value. So you can see how it is coming. I will put it on the white platform, then only you can see that how this pink color is being there. So this is your reading. Now the next duty is you have to see that what reading has been there in your burette. So that is the important point, because in the examination time you have to show the examiner this color. And then you have to show the burette. Whatever you are speaking, it should be there in your burette. So you can see on the top, it's 28, around 28. It's been marked like this. So bigger point is the numbering. Like this is 26. Then it has been divided into small parts. You'll see. Because to show in the video, it's become very difficult. But still, I'm trying to show you. I'm trying to focus my camera on the part, like how it's been there. Now I think now it's been clear. The longer line is related to the number, so that is 27. Now the small dots lines are there, that is 27.1, then 27.2, then 3 and 4. Then again you will get a middle line over here. So this part, we are talking about this part, that is this part. So this is when you come to this part, then you'll see to it that is let me adjust the camera first. Now I think now it's clear. So the bigger line is the number that has been pointing. This is 27. Then over here when you get the middle line, this is 27.5. It will come. Now again this is down, this is 20. Then again it is again bifurcated with the small lines. So let's focus on it. I'm trying to adjust my camera so that the value should be seen clearly. So this has 4 points, 28.1, 28.23 and then 4. So let's see what is coming. It's not 28.4. It's when I'm seeing with my eyes, then it is seeing about 28.3. So that is your reading that will come. So again, I'm telling you, it depends on the teacher to teacher ke what concentration they are using. So according to that, only you get the titer value. So I'm not telling you the exact concentration, that what concentration I have used for making the solutions. So, but I have just taught you how to do this experiment in the lab. And on this experiment, different questions questions comes, so that questions you have to attempt. So this is the procedure how you have to do and what you have to show when you're coming to the lab. So you have to, when the teacher come to you and when she'll ask to you, you have to show the color that is there in the conical flask and the reading in your burette. And when you are completed your experiment, please arrange your table very well, because I have just done it. So I also have to arrange my table properly. So I am just keeping all the solutions here. So this way we can see that all the chemicals are there and these solutions are there. And I have, my height is short, so I have put my burette on this particular table. So it's depend on you. If you are quite taller enough, you can put it on the slab, because the slab is white in color and it give you a good reading and good obs. So this thing, you can see how the burette has been filled. So this way we can see how the things are there. Let's focus on it, that the readings are coming, and I think now it's been clear to you. So this is the titration we have done, and questions comes on a different manner. So please attempt the questions, whatever they are in your book, so you can apply the value of it. Again, I am not telling you the concentration. I have just done the experiment, the procedure. So this way you can do it.